As we reflect on the lessons of the past, we need to acknowledge the delicate balance between financing today's prosperity on the one hand and safeguarding the well-being of future generations on the other. In Europe, the debt crisis, which unfolded over a decade ago, tested the resilience of our economies, financial systems, as well as the unity, the very fabric of the European Union. It exposed the vulnerabilities in our fiscal and banking systems, bringing to light critical lessons on fiscal policy, debt sustainability, and the health of the banking sector due to the strong sovereign bank nexus. Indeed, it tested the very existence of the single currency area. In what follows, I will reflect on these lessons in four key sectors. First, fiscal policy. Second, debt sustainability. Third, financial stability. And fourth, the interaction between monetary and fiscal policy. The challenges we face today, ranging from high debt levels to climate crisis, geopolitical risks posed by conflicts, geoeconomic fragmentation, demographic shifts, low productivity, and deglobalization trends, require us to remain vigilant and adaptive. Should we confront rising debt vulnerabilities, the need for innovative and sustainable fiscal solutions will be more urgent than ever. The decisions we make today will determine not only Europe's financial stability, but also the well-being of future generations. Striking the right balance between fostering growth, ensuring fiscal sustainability, and protecting the long-term interests of our societies is no easy task, but it is one we must face together.
Early history of public debt is very heavily European or Eurocentric. Sovereigns began to issue debt securities, borrow from bankers in connection with war, and wars were unusually frequent in Europe because of its physical and political geography. So for much of its history, the European continent was divided into literally hundreds of princely kingdoms and fiefdoms, many of which were no more than cities with relatively modest hinterlands butted up against one another. Charles Tilly, the eminent historical sociologist, emphasized this political factor when trying to explain Europe's financial development, and historical anthropologists like Jared Diamond have in turn linked that to Europe's physical geography as a landmass divided up by mountain ranges and river valleys that posed natural obstacles to the formation of larger territorial states.